Hi everyone, it's Beth with the F2M Sweethearts channel. It is week 22, and this week's topic is basically about us as partners and what we struggle with, the good, the bad, how we feel supported, how we don't feel supported, and kind of how we deal with that. A lot of times in our relationships, we kind of end up being not overlooked, but kind of put on the back burner as they're going through what they're going through. A lot of times everything in the relationship turns into trans this and trans that, and so we're going to talk about that this week, and it is Sunday, so you get me this week. So I just wanted to start off, talk a little bit about, first of all, like, what I went through, kind of in the process and where I'm at now and the good sides of things that have happened. Let's see here. In the beginning, there was a lot of things that I really struggled with, especially the very, very beginning of the process. It seems to me that it's really hard. First of all, because a lot of guys told Judah, basically, in this process, it's got to be about you, it's got to be about what you're going through, and you gotta focus on you, and you gotta pay attention to your needs, and this is all about you. And a lot of people at the same time said, you know, you gotta be willing to break up with Beth if it comes to that point in your relationship where you have to focus on you and you can't focus on your relationship with her. And that, for me, didn't sit very well. Constantly having people tell me in the trans community that we were probably going to break up, I thought was really kind of shitty. I got upset several times at different people, or just after different situations where I'd be like, what the fuck? You know, like, this is my relationship. Why is everyone butting in and telling me about how we're going to fail? You know, and a lot of people said, you know, we don't know anyone who has made it. And a lot of times, you know, my response was, well, you don't know me very well. You know, you don't know anything about me. You don't know about my relationship. And that's exactly what it is. It's about me and my relationship. So don't tell me, you know, what is going to happen or what isn't going to happen. And I think that that's, it's really hard because it's a well-intended thing in the trans community where guys are trying to give other trans guys support by, you know, encouraging them, because so much of the time they're discouraged from focusing on themselves. And this process, you do need to focus on yourself. That is an important part of the process. But what ends up happening a lot of times is that these other trans guys are, out of good intentions, encouraging, you know, your partners to be self-focused. And while being self-focused is a good thing, as far as really processing the transition, as far as coping and dealing and growing and developing where you are and things, that is good. Yes, you want to focus on yourself in that part of the transition. But at the same time, you can't just solely focus on yourself. So for me, I struggled a lot. I struggled a lot in the beginning of the transition. When Judah came out socially, I faced a lot of internal struggle because I was transitioning as well, and nobody gave me any credit for that. Nobody acknowledged that I was going through something as well. All these guys kept being like, Beth, this is not about you, this is not about you, this is not about you. And the hard part for me was that I'm the one with a full-time job. I'm the one who's paying our bills. I'm the one who has supported us for the last year while Judah has, been unemployed, and then he got a part-time job, but not enough to, you know, support us, and you know, I'm paying for this. This is, you know, my home, this is my life, this is my relationship. So yes, it is about me. And you can't just take me out of the equation there. If Judah was single, it would be solely about him. But he is in a relationship with me, and he lives with me, and I am paying our bills. So this really affects me as well. And that was really hard for me to deal with. The second thing, I had a little bit more difficult time with this than some people do, because I'm a nanny. So I work 50 to 60 hours a week in someone else's home, in essentially a different life, in a straight family with other straight families, hanging out with straight moms and hanging out with people who are in, and no, when I say straight, people sometimes get offended by this by saying that I'm classifying them. What I mean is that there aren't queer people in the area that I work, that are families. And so for me, that was really hard. I was essentially living in this world that I had nothing to relate with a lot of these people. My relationship is not that simple. I can't just get knocked up and have a baby. And, I mean, I could go to the bar, find some guy, get drunk, you know, that could always happen. I'd have to be really drunk. But that was a joke. For anyone who is concerned about a relationship, no, that's not going to happen. And so essentially I live Monday through Friday in an entirely different world that I don't belong in. And then I would come home and everything would be trans. And I personally, I'm not trans. I'm queer, but I'm not trans. I'm me. And so to essentially have every aspect of my life become about something other than me was really hard. Because I'm raising a kid in another family. I'm in a bunch of straight families that have no knowledge of queer people, or their knowledge is very limited, and so having a discussion with them requires a lot of explanation. So, and then, you know, being with a bunch of trans people all the time. Not that I don't love trans people, but sometimes it's really hard. You know, I got really lucky in my relationship. We had a little bit of a rough patch after Judy came out, and basically I got to a point where I was really desperate, and I said, you know, this is a partnership, this is a team, and I need you to be a part of this team. I need you to do certain things for me, you know, and this is what I need. And sometimes it really has nothing to do with, like, the trans stuff. Like, it just has to do with a relationship. Like, in a relationship, you need to be a team. You need to be a partnership. And so sometimes you get so overwhelmed with all of the trans things that you forget that you're still in a relationship that has normal things that you need to have happen. You need to support each other. That's just a basic aspect of any relationship. And so I, you know, I talked to Judah and, you know, basically was like, hey, I need these things. These are what I need. This is what I need for our relationship outside of all of the trans stuff as just a relationship for this to work. And Judah is amazing, and he, has never once discredited what I do in our relationship. And he always acknowledges that I work hard, and that I support us, and that I am sacrificing a lot of things in my life for us to be able to be here and be where he is. And he respects me for that, and he is more than willing to jump on board and to make the meals, and, you know, he cooks for me every night, and he makes sure that our, you know, our house is straightened when I come home, and that my bed is made, and that my clothes are put away, and he does a lot of things that to a lot of people would be very emasculating, but he sees it more as that this is what I need, and this is where we're at in this time, and he only has a part-time job right now, and so he's the one who has the time to do those things. So he does them, and he takes it all in stride, and Additionally, he stands up when people put my side of the relationship down. People say, this is not about you. He gives me credit for that. So that's really, I mean, I don't know what else to offer as far as, you know, how else I would suggest to people. But communication, you got to talk to them. You have to tell them what you need. Sometimes they just don't know. Like, they just don't get it. And you really just need to say, hey, this is what I need. And if you get to that point in your relationship where you need something, you got to ask. You got to say, I need these things. I need you to do this for me. And if they love you, if they are ready to hear that, and they may need to hear it several times, then they will be open to that, and they will listen to you. And that's what your relationship is all about. So I hope that this helps you. I just communicate, talk to them, listen to them, set really reasonable boundaries, and start small. If you feel like there's a lot of things that you need, and, you know, prioritize. These are the most important things that you could do for me right now. So maybe three things that they can help you with that would make your life easier, or it'd make you feel more understood, or it'd make you feel more supported. And start there. Start small and be willing to compromise with them in respect to their needs as well. So, you know, compromise, respect each other, and communicate. And that's all I got for this week. I hope that encourages you. I hope that's helpful. I love you all. And wherever you are in the world, just know that you are loved and supported.